Well, this is the High Tech Zone Sports Centre Gymnasium here in Chengdu in China. And welcome to table tennis action and the singles finals for this World University Summer Games. First, it's going to be the women's singles final. Two fantastic players are going to battle for the gold medal. Fifth game of best of seven final here in the women's singles. Unusual serve, but Qian gets the job done. Bouncing a lot higher over the net. Qian did nicely and gave her a little, her opponent a little steer there as well. Oh, lovely play from Qian. She was working hard there. Great adjustment off the net cord, and then great depth on those shots from Qian, and really grinding out another point. He establishes that 2-point lead. Another epic rally. These are heating up. Excellent work from both players. Shame sometimes when those rallies have to end. Big pressure now on Itasawa in this fifth game. That brings up 4 game points for Qian. There she goes to a 3-2 lead now. And she's done it like she did in her two previous game wins with a big streak of points to close it out. 5 on the trot for Qian. In game number 5, that was tied up at 6-all a moment ago. And it ended up being a pretty comfortable win, just like her other two game wins in the second and the third. 11-6 that one. Well, it's looking more and more likely at this point as Itasawa closes in that we're going to go to a deciding game in this gold medal match. We'll see, though. That's good play from Qian. Took her chance there. She needed to. Oh, boy, I love, bet you she'd love to start to put some pressure now on Itasawa. This could be her opportunity with two serves coming. Nicely done. Set up with a good serve. And then again, big forehand winner. She's won 3 of the last 4 points now. Oh, now the crowd get excited. Itasawa now changing her mind, going for the backhand serve. Oh, paid off too. So that brings up 3 game points. Good match this one. Lovely change up by Qian to go across the table. Seeing that pattern of points unfold in the match. Earlier on, so 1 game point saved by Qian. 2nd game point for Itasawa. And that is that. It's 11-8 in the 6th game. Well done to Itasawa Kaioka of Japan. And that game win means we're going to a deciding game for the gold medal. Oh. again on another day that might have fallen on Jian's side of the table. Not today. Just extraordinary skills from both players again. Anita Sawa again able to put the disappointment of that unlucky break in that last point. Puts it behind her. And then she gets a lucky break over the net. Another excellent point from both players. And it's 3-all now. This pattern of play has been a feature of most of these games in this final. Very close in the early stages of each game. With the players basically trading points. Well, first time one of these two has been in front by more than 1 point in this final game. We saw Ida Sawa call that timeout earlier on, and it enabled her to just hit the reset button and close out a couple of points to win a game. That was incredible play from both players. And just like that, that 2-point advantage that Ida Sawa enjoyed has been wiped. And it's come off the back of that timeout. 3 points in a row now for Jian. And she takes the lead again. Oh, what a match we've got here. Well, the crowd absolutely loving this run of points at the moment. So does the Chinese coaching team. Could this be the difference? Now Ida Sawa in a tight spot. She's conceded 4 points in a row. Oh, how good was that shot? What an amazing shot there from Ida Sawa, given the circumstances of the score. She put that right on the edge of the table. This forehand here, just a centimetre inside the edge. Brilliant shot. Oh, we pause for a big deep breath. I think we're going to need it. Lovely change up from Ida Sawa there. We've seen her take the pace off the ball there. Go for the sliced shot a little bit more there. Well, that 4-point run. And Jian helped to a 2-point lead. We're back to 7-all in the race to 11. Well, every shot, every point, absolutely critical now. It's a 1-point game. What a women's singles final. We've been going just 1 minute short of an hour now. And now our apps that we've got. A very tight finish to this match. Oh, cranked up beautifully there. Ida Sawa not able to get a good swing at that one. That was really clever from Jian. Right at the body. Excellent tactic. 2 points away from victory. This is a massive point now for both players. And it goes the way of Chian, and that sets up 2 gold medal points. Chian Tianyi on the cusp of 4 gold medals at these university games. Can she do it? Back comes Itasawa. She's got another serve as well. Second gold medal point for Chian Tianyi of China. Four gold medals for Chian Tianyi at these university games. What a massive effort. Fantastic singles final between her and Japan's Itasawa Kaioka. But it's all smiles for Chian, and rightly so. What a win for her. And she wins this match 11-9 in the deciding set. So there we are, the medalists in the women's singles of table tennis. What a game for Chian Tianyi, having also won golds in the mixed doubles, women's doubles, and the women's teams. Well, it's time now for the men's singles final here at Summer University Games in Chengdu in China. So Joe up 2-1, and he's serving to start the fourth. I don't know if this is coincidence, but the player who wins the first point of each game so far has gone on to win that game. So Joe, see if that trend continues. Oh, well, what a disappointing end there to an amazingly skillful rally again. Fantastic play again from Xu, all set up by that lovely backhand. And again, Joe not in position. Love the way Xu plays that shot late. Joe is not sure which way he's going. Again, Xu is on fire right now. That's 4 of the last 5 points, and they're all being winners as well. There he goes again. This is fantastic play. This time off the forehand, and Joe not able to get anywhere near that one. 6 game points, and he's got it. Brilliant effort from Xu, and we're locked up. What a comeback from him. That game seemed to go very fast. It only took 6 minutes. As Xu, fantastic all-round play, wins that game 11-4, and we're locked up at 2-2. So Joe with the next couple of serves. Just to really think about how to execute and where to put them. The timeout. Oh, that's just too good. Love the finish here from Xu. Swing away from Joe Kai. Beautifully played. Got the break there, Joe. Again, a couple of metres behind the table. Hard luck for Shu. Just a fraction long, and Shu, he was down by six, remember, 8-2. Joe just composing himself off that timeout. He's got three game points in this fifth game. And that was a stylish finish from Joe Kai. Big forehand, and he claims this fifth game, 11-7. He's on the brink now with Joe Kai just one game away from victory. He leads 3-2. Just like his opponent at the moment. Oh, brilliant. How good was that? That was terrific table tennis from both players. And Shu needed every ounce of his skill set there to win that point. Oh, his eyes lit up, though, with that runaround forehand. Some great action. Goes that little snap backhand again. Shu has had a lot of success with that shot. Very late. And he disguised that one really well. He had it below the height of the table, so Joe couldn't quite see that one. Oh, yes! What a rally! That brings a smile to the fans' faces. Check the depth out on those shots. Right on the edge. Shot after shot and shoot. Looking a bit distraught there, wasn't he? But what a rally. Oh, again, it's perhaps a bit tighter now. I'm going back through the scorecard here, and most games have been, it's been a bit of a margin by now. Ooh, good serve from Joe there. Surprising Shu a little bit. Way more pace on that one. We've seen that big forehand bear fruit too for Shu. He's still playing with a very positive attitude. Still going to his natural instincts of attacking. Swing and a miss that time. Joe will take what he can. Again, you can see that late decision to play the ball. Just giving them that split second more to create the angle. Oh, these next few points huge here for Shu. Yeah, beautifully set up again. Back to even Stevens. Errors from both players. Unforced errors like that have been few and far between for the last little while. And now, sweaty palm territory coming for both of these two with so much at stake. Oh, fantastic backhand play from Joe. Breathtaking speed again from both players. shoe at full stretch there. So at 8-6, this is the first time that either player has been ahead by more than 1 point in this sixth game. Oh, shoe fans will be sighing with relief there. It's heart in the mouth stuff now, isn't it? Shoe must win this game, remember, to send this match to a decider. Joe wins it. He's got the gold medal. Oh. He went left and then went right. It was superbly done by Joe Kai. That one and then that one. Too much for Shu. Now Joe with two serves. He can serve this out. Big points in the match now. Oh! How did that happen right there? That was extraordinary. It was hit and hope from Shu that time. And that might just have kept him alive in this gold medal match. Brilliant play. Well, here we are. He's on the cusp now. This is gold medal point number one for Joe Kai, and he's going to have two of them if required. Shoot a serve. Gold medal to Joe Kai. Fantastic performance from him. Got him a tight midway through the match. But he reset himself brilliantly and came through to win in style. So it's gold to Joe Kai in the men's singles here in Chengdu. And he claims it in six games. Shu will come again one day. He's a fine player. But today is the day for Joe Kai. He wins the gold in the men's singles, claiming that sixth game, 11 points to 8.